Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily transform photos into super sharp dithered images. Basically, the process of dithering reduces the number of colors in your image based on a specified amount and transforms them into tiny dots or other shapes that interpolates continuous tone. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. The first step is to change its size and resolution. Press Ctrl-Alt-I on Windows or Command-Option-I on a Mac, or go to Image and Image Size. If the resolution isn't 72 pixels per inch, just type it in. Change its width or height to 300 pixels. Then click OK. To fit it onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to File, Export, and Save for Web Legacy. Click the plus icon a few times to fill the preview box with your image. For this project, we'll leave the preset at its unnamed default as a GIF file. By the way, the letter G in GIF is pronounced like the first letter of giraffe or giant, according to Stephen Wilhite, the inventor of GIFs. Choose Selective. We have three choices below No Dither: Diffusion, Pattern, and Noise. Diffusion gives us squarish dots. Pattern gives us a combination of squarish dots, X's, and plus sign patterns. Noise gives us a rather messy combination of squarish dots. You can choose whatever looks good to you, but for this example, I'll choose diffusion. We can choose the number of colors in our image from 2 all the way to 256. 2 reduces the number of colors in our image to just 2. Notice in the color table, we can see the two colors. In a minute, I'll show you how we can change any of the colors that comprise our image. We can add more colors by pressing the down arrow on our keyboard, which toggles through them one by one. Or we can open the flyout list and click a number. For this image, I'll choose 5. To change any of the colors, double-click on the color you want to change and pick a new color to replace it with. If you want to try a different color, simply double-click back on that color and pick another color. Then click Save. I'll rename the file Dither Image, but you can name it whatever you like. Save it to your desktop for easy access and click Save. Go to File and Open. Open your desktop. Click the dithered image and click Open. Fill your canvas with it by pressing Ctrl or Command 0. Go to Image and Image Size. In either the width or the height, let's type in 3000 pixels. Make sure Resample is checked and that Nearest Neighbor Hard Edges is picked. Let's zoom into it by opening our zoom tool and dragging over a small area of our image. Super crisp, super sharp.
This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.